We're given f of x equals the quantity 5x plus 2 divided by the quantity x minus 3, and we're asked to find f inverse of x, or the inverse of the given function. To remember how to do this, I think it's important to recognize that the inverse function is going to undo the operation of the original function. For example, if x is the input into the function f and y is the output, this y becomes the input into the inverse function, which returns the original value of x. Which means, when we're given the equation of the function, we want to find the inverse. The first step is to write the original function in terms of x and y, and then we'll interchange the x and y variables. So the original function can be written as y equals the quantity 5x plus 2 divided by the quantity x minus 3. So the inverse function will be x equals the quantity 5y plus 2 divided by y minus 3. So this y, which is the output of function f, is now the input, or the x value, for the inverse function. And these x's, which are the inputs of f, are now the y values, or outputs, of the inverse function. And now we're left to solve this for y, and then replace y with inverse function notation. So because the right side is in fraction form, we could put this x over 1 and then cross multiply, meaning x times the quantity y minus 3 must equal 1 times the quantity 5y plus 2. Or we could just multiply both sides by the quantity y minus 3. Either way, we would have x times the quantity y minus 3 equals 5y plus 2. Let's go ahead and clear these parentheses. So we'll distribute here. We have xy minus 3x equals 5y plus 2. Now remember, our goal here is to solve this for y, which means if the term has a y in it, we want it on one side, and if it doesn't, we want it on the other side. Let's start by subtracting 5y on both sides. So this would give us xy minus 5y minus 3x equals 2. Now we'll add 3x to both sides. This is 0, so now we have xy minus 5y is going to be equal to 3x plus 2. Now to solve this for y, we're actually going to have to factor out the common factor of y. So we'll have y times the quantity x minus 5 equals 3x plus 2. Now we're one step away. We need to divide both sides by the quantity x minus 5. So we have y equals quantity 3x plus 2 divided by the quantity x minus 5. So for our last step, let's go ahead and replace y with inverse function notation. F inverse of x is equal to quantity 3x plus 2 divided by the quantity x minus 5. So here's the inverse function that we're asked to find. I hope you found this helpful.